Welcome to Kuros BI. Today we're going to be going over how to build out your own custom theme using the tools available for you out on KratosBI.com. My name is Chris Wagner. Let's get to it. Out on KratosBI.com, we've made a number of tools available for you out under the Get Started with Power BI. Today we're going to be talking about and using the Kratos BI visuals file. So it's really easy. Download this. Open this up in the latest version of Power BI Desktop. Once you're inside of it, quick lay of the land. These are all of the standard Power BI visuals that are available inside of the service. You can test out using other custom visuals, see how it works. But anytime you want to make a theme change, it's really important for you to go through and see how each of the visuals looks to ensure that you're not making any changes that are going to throw things way off. We could go in and test out. We could go test out some of the standard visuals that are available inside the service by clicking on View and then selecting some of the other visuals that are there. You can kind of start to get a feel for how these visuals would look under these different themes that are available inside the service. Power BI has made a number of different changes to this in the December release that gives a ton of additional features available for you. But we're going to start off with the default theme, the new default theme that comes with Power BI. We're going to customize this theme for our use case. We're going to go and we're going to customize the theme for a good friend of mine, Bruce. He works at Metro Bank in the UK. Metro Bank has been a customer success story for Microsoft for a number of years now. I was fortunate enough where I got to see them present this solution. But I'm going to come out and I'm going to take a look at the website to try and find out what are the standard colors that Metro Bank uses, right? Now, many companies will have a marketing department. Well, they'll have all of that information already published, and you can just go up to a style guide and find out all the colors, the logos, the fonts that they recommend. But if I was just starting out as a consultant wanting to do something for Metro Bank, I'd go out to this site, I'd grab this, and I go to a website called stylify.me.com. What this does is it allows you to easily go in, paste in the information, hit of the website, hit Stylify Me, and it's going to go back out and it's going to give me all of the visuals or all of the web colors that are used in the website, so I can create my palette and start to go from there. Now, once you've done that, pop open your favorite text editor and then go out and grab some of these colors that are available on this site. So as I'm building this out, I'm looking for different colors and I'm starting to think about like how I could use this inside the background. So in this case, this E color here, this might be a real good palette color to start to use, you know, the background on the page, whereas a color like this might be a really good background. So we're just gonna try that out and see how this looks. Now that I've got my colors, let's go back over to Power BI Desktop and let's go in and try out the new customization themes that are available for you. Staying on the View tab, there's this new feature called Customize Current Theme that when you click on it, it allows you to go in and define various aspects about the theme. So I'm going to go through, I'm going to grab in all of my big custom visuals here. Any place where I see a red, I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna make sure that we get the red that they're using all the time, right? If I'm gonna change something up and make it brighter, right? I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna make sure I change that color everywhere that I go, right? So we have consistent colors as we're looking at the palette. Advanced, we're gonna run through. Here's where we're going to be able to go in and make sure that we're using the values that Metro Bank uses. This will just help bring consistency to everything at Metro Bank, making sure that people are able to understand it. And if they were to embed this inside their website, you know, make this available to clients, it would look consistent and feel right wherever you are. No, I was looking at their website. I think they're using an Arial. Not 100% sure, but one of the big things that this allows you to do is go through and make sure that you're using a consistent font throughout your entire dashboard. This is really helpful in making sure things look right and they pop accordingly. I'm going to continue to go through, and I'm going to look at my different levels here. So we have our border, and we're not going to actually do a background. So we're going to talk about our wallpaper. We're going to try using the Metro Bank Blue for the wallpaper. I think this looks really nice. And when we talk, that's the wallpaper, that's the canvas in the background of the page. But when we talk about the page itself background, here's where I think it's going to look really good to try this light gray. Let's give her a shot. So use that. And then for our visuals, that means if we're going to use a background of that light gray, we should do that here too. This allows us to keep consistency between them, knowing that we could always come back and change it if we really wanted to. On the visuals, one of the things I do like to do is I like to keep the border on, set it to the same color as the background, and give it a radius of 3 pixels. What this does is it creates this nice little beveled edge on all of the visuals, makes it look really nice, right? Okay, all that stuff's good. There's nothing to do there. We covered all of these things. Now here's another thing where we're going to go in, and what we're talking about here is the filter pane. So the filter pane is this guy right here, and I found it really pops to make it that if we're using that wallpaper color, a dark wallpaper color, if we do the same thing here, and then we and then apply and save. Now, we're gonna find out how well does this look. Realistically, this is not too shabby. I think we're missing something. That page background didn't come through the way I had intended it to. So let's take a look at what happened there. So if I look at my page background, there we go. My page background was set to 100% transparent, so then I wouldn't have seen the gray background. Now I change that, and now we get this gray background. Now, okay, so that did fix that, but do you see the issue? I lost my nice clean bevels there. So I'm actually going to go in and change that. I'm going to set this to a nice light blue because I don't like it. And there we go. This gives us a nice clean pane. We have these beveled edges on all of our items. In fact, I don't like the bevel. I want it to be a little more bevely. Well, simple enough, real easy to come in here, change that, make that maybe a 6, right? Apply and save. And boom. Now I've got more of a rounded bevel on all of my images. As I go down and look at my my chart, I can see that for the most part, everything in here looks pretty good. This looks like it's a decent start for using the Metro Bank colors. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna go up to my visual here. And well, first thing, whoopsies, just forgot something. First thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save this so I don't overwrite my file. And I've got that all together. I'm going to now export my current theme. I'm going to call this one Metro Bank theme. I'm going to save that up. I'm going to bundle that off. And then I'm going to send that over to Bruce at Metro Bank. All right. Now again, let's quick review. Started with the Kratos BI visuals file. Bruce. Save the name to something else, even though I did that almost last. Went out to the website, got the website, found a list of the colors, opened the file up, went to the View tab, went into the Visuals, and went down to Customize the Current Theme to really dig in and start to play with how this is going to look and feel. All right? So this is how you can build out a custom theme. As you can see, it's pretty easy, and by having all of these, the Power BI visuals here, it's super easy to check out that everything looks good, it's easy to read. I don't have anything that really stands out as, oh my gosh, I can't read this at all. So it looks really pretty good. Thank you very much, and that's how you create your own custom theme. Super easy, barely an inconvenience. Thank you for watching. As you remember, check out kratosbi.com. Go out, buy me a coffee. I'll ship you one of these little stickers. I love Power BI stickers. And thank you for all your support. Have a great day. Bonus content. All right. If you're looking to take this to the next level, check out Power BI Tips. We'll be doing a special video on this sometime in the future. Or we're going to be going out, checking out their new advanced theme generator. This thing is really cool. And this, like, talk about taking up your customizing to the next level. This really takes it up to 11. So they've always had the ability to go in and, in the latest version, they've really upped what you can do inside here. You know, you used to just be able to come out, well, you could do a lot, but one of the first things they did was you could add in some specific colors from your palette. Enter them, right? Yeah, you can enter them by pasting them in and create, you know, download the theme. Now though, they've really outdone themselves. If you go over to this Properties tab, you can go in and you can set on many of the visuals. You can go out and you can configure everything about them and then download the theme and apply that. So this is truly like ninja level stuff.